Then let's make some effects. Also, for some of you might be interesting, the convolution filter. It's kind of very mystical thing. I think most of people using it in Photoshop without any idea how this actually works. But, for example, very practical approach, especially in TouchDesigner, using convolution filter, you can easily create some filters which are not existing in TouchDesigner, like sharpness. For that, we just need Wikipedia. Or you just go to browser and look for convolution kernel, for example, 3x3. And you will find a lot of pages, image kernels, explain it visually. Also, like in Wikipedia, there are a bunch of filters built on principle. Easily to say, there are this table 3x3, and that is a coefficient how the pixels around the current pixel will be mixed together. And that easy mathematic, completely ununderstandable for artists, but you don't need to understand that, you just need to copy and paste and know where to copy and paste. So, and here you have like a menu blur. Okay, so let's try. I just put it side by side and I will take some picture. Let's take this room. Disable all unneeded viewers. Then it makes now some error because it's need logically a table. And like everything in TouchDesigner, what belongs to table, you need to create a dot. So I go to dot and create a table. Here I can say exact dimension and I need 3x3. So I enable that and I say 3x3. Then I just copy and paste these values. So you can see I need to paste that value on all angles. Wait. Yeah. On all angles. Then I need that value on vertical cross. Here, 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 and here. And in the middle, I need 0.25. Then I will put a null and drop this null here. It became a bit softer, so it's not that super intense blur. Okay, emboss filter. Copy paste the table. -2. And you see interactively how the picture transforms. It's already something cool in this effect. But I will continue. You see, middle is the current pixel. So after I entered one, it became brighter. It's just like mixing values of all surrounding pixels. -1, -1. So now we almost have edge effect. Then I add one here and one here, and we have emboss filter. Then we copy and paste that again. Go here, do sharpen. We do 5 in the middle, 0 on angle, -1, -1, and -1, and -1. So now we have sharpened picture. So that's where it works. Then you just can go on internet. There are tons of these kernels. You can find it easily. We can find unsharpened mask effect. Can be realized using this simple operator. But out of this convolve, we have a bunch of already done effects. So we have emboss.